Regie here, your friendly neighborhood bodybuilder and comic book collector, and I want to welcome you to another one of my vlogs. In this vlog, I want to spend a little bit of time talking about why I don't talk about prices in my videos. And I want to do this because I continue to get the question from people, and I have attempted to respond to that question in the comment section of various videos. I've alluded to it in other longer videos that were on a different topic, and the question was asked in a live stream, for example, and I tried to answer it there. But what I've discovered is that it may be more helpful to actually record this as a standalone video. And that way, whenever the question comes up, I can actually point people to that video for the answers that they seek. And so that is part of the reason why I am doing this. My hope is that it will help people to better understand my perspective as it relates to talking about price. And I don't know if it's going to make people feel better about it, but at a minimum, it is designed to help people to understand my perspective and why I choose not to talk about it. And, you know, people are going to agree with it or disagree with it. I think that that's okay, because that's, you know, that's what this is all about. But I at least want to put it out there in a comprehensive manner where my thoughts are as it relates to this. To some degree or another, when the question comes up, it's almost like people think that by knowing how much I pay for a comic, that there is a tremendous amount of insight that comes along with knowing that number. And to some degree or another, I fundamentally disagree with that. And I fundamentally disagree with it because there are so many caveats that like go with price that I think the utility of knowing the number isn't all that helpful. And the further away that you actually get from a purchase, it becomes even less relevant and potentially even more misleading. And here's what I mean by that. Unless you know all of the circumstances around a purchase, including like sales tax and where I bought it and how much I paid for it and my relationship with the person that sold it to me, the context around the purchase, whether I paid cash or whether I used a debit card, whether I've done business with that person previously and that's why I was able to get it for that price. All of those things, I think, have to be given to someone for someone really to understand why you were able to get that book for the price that you were able to get it for. And then more importantly than that, you also need to know the exact date in which the book was purchased, because we know that this is a dynamic market that we collect in. And without knowing the exact date of a purchase, then how can you know what other factors were influencing that price? Again, it's about the context. Without the context, you have a number. And a number is a single data point that may or may not be misleading. The other part of it is, if you think about this YouTube machine, these videos live forever. And so if I bought a comic at a dip from a friend in 2017, and we are now in 2019, knowing the price of that book does not help you at all to know how much you should actually pay for that comic without all of the context. So imagine trying to record a video in which you talk about and show this book. You would have to provide someone with all of that context for them to actually be able to make some decisions based upon the number that is provided. Personally, where I try to stick is more with the philosophy of buying and collecting comics. Right. I try to give people things to think about so that they can make more informed decisions for their collection. For me to sit and talk about how much I pay makes it about me. And that's not what the goal is. The goal is about you as a collector and you being more empowered to make decisions about your collection. Whether you buy, sell, hold, whether you read this or read that, I try to give people things to think about so that they can be empowered, they can be strengthened, they can be better collectors and better enjoy the hobby. But for me to sit and talk about price makes it about me. And this vlog is not in any way, shape, or form a criticism of anyone that has asked me about price or talks about price. That's not my gig. That's not my gig. If a channel is about deals and telling people you want to buy this book before this book goes up in price and here is the price, to me, that makes sense to talk about it. If your gig is I got a sweet deal, you too can get a sweet deal. Knowing the price in real time, I could see that. For me, this channel is about new collectors, those that are newly returning to the hobby of comic books, and to some degree or another, those that have been in the hobby for a while. And the channel is really all about wherever those people are in this hobby, helping them to be smarter collectors, helping them to maybe avoid some of the pitfalls that I've encountered. And so to that point, it's about philosophy. It's about slowing down and thinking about things. The channel is about creating space for you to actually think, where maybe some of the emotion is maybe stripped away or reduced, where you may have a little bit of additional insight, maybe some contrarian thoughts other than your own to at least consider to be able to make informed decisions. And so in my head, talking about the exact price that Regie paid doesn't necessarily help you per se. And some might listen to this and say, well, it's a splitting of hairs, but it's a splitting of hair that makes sense to me, you know? So my hope is that this helps people just a little bit, better understand some of where I'm coming from. So the other part of this, though, is it generally makes me uncomfortable to talk about price. And it makes me uncomfortable because I grew up in a pretty religious family and in a family that believed in modesty. One of my mom's favorite phrasings is, don't be prideful. Don't be prideful. That's what she always says to me. And I am always trying to walk that line of not being too prideful. Because when you sit and talk about the things that you have, which is essentially what we do in this YouTube thing when it comes to comics, right? You're like, hey, look at my new book, right? That could be heard as being prideful, especially when you throw price into there. Right? Let's say that I'm able to get a book for a dollar and you cannot find that book for less than 10. How does that make you feel? Right? Regie got it for a dollar. I should be able to get it for a dollar, but I can't. I have to pay $10. How would you feel about that? And then if I'm sitting there on my channel basically saying, hey, I got this for a dollar. That could be viewed as being prideful. And I don't want to be that guy, right? I don't want to be that guy. And again, this is not a criticism of anyone that chooses to do it, because I think that people have to be, if you're a YouTuber and you create content, it doesn't matter the size of your audience. I think that you have to be authentic to yourself. And for me to sit and talk about price is not being authentic to myself. It's viewed as being prideful, at least in my mind. And so because of my upbringing, because I was told not to be envious of other people's personal possessions, because you never know how they got those personal possessions, right? They could have been given to them. They could have earned them. And it's not about what they have. That's again, how I was raised. It's not about what someone else has. And that's why when people say to me, you know, I'm jealous of your collection. Well, don't be jealous. That's not the point of this. I don't want people to be jealous of the comics that I have. I want people to look at what I've been able to do and say, I can do that too. Or even better, I can do better than that. To me, that's cool. When I look at other people's collections, I'm always like, wow, that's a dope book. Yeah, I wish I had that 9.8. You know, you think about my buddy Nerdy Girl, man. She has an amazing collection. You know, she also has an amazing stack of books that she has for sale, right? And I look at her and I can talk with her and I am not envious of what she's been able to do. I am in awe. I am inspired. I am encouraged by what she has been able to do. And this is not about me trying to tell you how you feel. What this is about is, again, me trying to articulate how I think and why I do some of the things that I do. I'm offering people a little bit of insight into my thought process. You know, I'm offering a little bit of insight into these things that my mother has whispered to me over the years about being prideful and envious and all that good stuff. And I'm very thankful for my upbringing. Super thankful. I can poke fun at it and all that good stuff, but I'm very thankful for my my Midwestern roots. But you know, the thing is that I want people to be able to watch these videos and not feel that I am talking down to them. I don't want people to feel that they are less than because they don't have the books that I have. I don't want people to listen to the videos and think that because they cannot get the deal that I received for a book, that they are doing something wrong. I choose to focus more on the philosophy of things, my general approach. And so, you know, here's one of the things is I get sometimes some good deals from people. Why is that? It's because I go to shops and I meet shop owners and I spend time talking with them and developing relationships with them. I don't go in and ask for deals. I go in and have a genuine conversation with them as people, as business owners, as people that love the hobby of collecting comics. So that's part of it is, and I've spoken about this before, I try not to be a transactional person, right? I try to be a relationship person. I try to take the time to actually connect with people. And that's why if you listen to every video, at the end, I'm like, hey, if you need to reach out to me, feel free to reach out to me at regiecollects@instagram.com, right? I mean, not Instagram, but at Instagram, right? And the thing is I enjoy having the conversations because I learn something from people, but you also develop a relationship with folks as well. And people like to give deals and breaks to people that they like. And so if you think about some of the hunting videos that I've done, those are some of the tidbits that I kind of sprinkle in there to say, think about the philosophy of how I approach this. And people have said to me, how do you get a great deal? Well, you get a great deal by getting to know people. You don't necessarily get it by trying to force the price down. And again, maybe you do. That's just not how I do it, right? So I'll offer some additional insight. I tend to pay cash. Cash is king, right? So I go in the shops and I will have conversations. And if the shop indicates, you know, that there is a certain price if you pay with card and there's a certain price with cash, I am going to the ATM. I am going to the ATM and I'll be right back with some cash for you because cash is king and people like to avoid, like eBay, right? They like to avoid fees and things like that. They like to avoid anything that takes money out of their pocket. And so to that point, people are willing to offer deals if you pay cash. And if they like you, even better, right? And then another thing that I do, and a couple of people have actually asked me about this just recently. The question was, do you examine every comic before you buy? Yes, I do. Unless it is like a super cheap comic, right? If it's like a dollar comic, I'm going to eyeball it, but I'm not going to take it out of the plastic and look at it, especially if I'm buying some higher dollar things, right? But if I'm spending, you know, $20, you know, $15, I am pulling you out of the plastic and I am going to examine you. And, you know, just a little bit of insight into that. I've never had a shop owner or shop employee push back on my desire to pull a comic out of the plastic. And oftentimes what I do is I ask them, I'll make a statement like, hey, I want to, you know, take this out of the bag. I want to look at it. Do you want to do it or do you want me to do it? And a lot of shop owners actually will just take it out of the bag for me and then hand me the book. A lot of them are like, I had one guy be like, hey, do you collect a lot? I'm like, yeah, I buy a lot of Amazing Spider-Man. The guy was like, do you have number one? I'm like, yeah, I have number one. He's like, oh, go ahead. You can pull the books out of the plastic because if you have number one, you know how to handle comics. And this is at a con. It was hilarious. But I always take the comic out of the plastic and I examine it. And from the way that I handle books, I think people also know that I am looking for certain things, that I'm not just trying to just come in and get a smoking deal on something, right? So I look at the comic and I'm essentially trying to grade the comic that is in front of me. I'm looking for defects. I'm looking for pressable defects. I'm looking for non-pressable defects. And I'm trying to evaluate whether the price that I'm seeing on this comic and maybe the grade that has been given to it, trying to figure out whether that makes sense in my mind. I also pull out my pricing guide and I'm like, okay, this is what you're asking. This is your grade. This is my grade. Let's look up the FMV and let's see whether this thing makes sense. And I do this right in front of the shop owner. I'm super transparent about it because why hide anything? And then if I see that there are defects there that are not necessarily reflected in the price of the comic, then I try to have a conversation with the shop owner where I'm like, hey, here's what I'm seeing. Did you notice that? You know, what is your thought on the grade? Because I think the grade is a 5. You have it at a 7.5. You know, can we do something about this? Right. And it's not coming from a place of I'm trying to get this book as cheap as possible. It comes from a place of, hey, here are the defects that you and I are looking at this book at the same time. And can we agree that it is not a 7.5? And I'll be honest with you, that has worked incredibly well. Incredibly well, because I have had shop owners be like, oh, I didn't even see that. I didn't even see that tear right there. I didn't even see that ding right there. Oh yeah, you know what? That was misgraded. That was mispriced. It happens a fair bit, but it comes from a genuine place of I want to examine this book and make sure that I'm paying an appropriate price for this book. And I've been able to have the price of books bought down. And let's say that I can't, that the shop owner is like, nah, the price is what the price is. Cool. Thumbs up to that. I'm not buying that. And that also happens. I did it just yesterday, in fact, with a black cover regular series Wolverine number 1. And the plastic book looked great. Pulled it out of the plastic and I saw all kinds of like fingerprints and smudges. And you know, it's a black cover front and back to some degree or another. And there were fingerprints across the entire book. And some of that could have been clean, but there were also two looked like it had been impacted during the printing process, because there were two like deep grooves on the lower left-hand corner that actually ran through the first half of the book. And I think somewhere along the production process, that book had been impacted. And I'm looking at it, and I've had some other books like that with that similar kind of defect, that it takes a lot to get those dings out, a lot to get those worked out of it. And so I'm like looking at the price, looking at this grade, looking at the damage, I'm like, I'm going to pass on that. The guy couldn't understand that, but I'm like, bro, it's right there. You can see it, you know? But you also, you know, can't be afraid to actually walk away from a deal. So these are some of the things that I do when I'm out there in the wild to affect the price of the book. And these are the things that I want to try to communicate to people versus the amount of money that Regie paid for this comic on this day 5 years ago. That's not necessarily, to me, that helpful. Unlike, what is the philosophy? What is the thought process? How do you approach this thing? Again, if you think about what the channel is about, it's about you. It's about helping you to be smarter about the hobby, helping you to avoid some of the mistakes that I've made, some of the things where I've overpaid. If I told you guys some of the prices that I paid for some stuff, especially early on, you guys would look at me like, you're an idiot. But mistakes happen. But every time you make a mistake, you learn from it. Every time you make a mistake, if you are paying attention, you learn from it. But this is about you. It's not about me. But again, I wanted to record this vlog just to provide you guys with some insight into how I think, because I want you guys to continue enjoying the content that I put out on this channel. And I don't want the price to be a lingering issue where people don't necessarily understand why I don't disclose it. It's not that I'm hiding something. It's not that I don't want to be forthcoming. I struggle with the utility of that information. And I'm the kind of guy, yes, I have a bias for action, but I also skip to the end. I see a challenge, I skip to the end. And if I don't see how me doing something results in a different type of outcome, then it's not something that I do. And so disclosing a price, for me, I don't see how that helps you, especially years from now when you might be listening to these videos. But then there's also the point that it makes me personally uncomfortable and it makes me less than genuine of a person. And so I hope that this helps. As always, I want to thank you guys for taking the time to listen to this vlog. And if you need to reach out to me with a question, comment, thought, concern, don't hesitate to do so at REGIECOLLECTS on Instagram at REGIECOLLECTS@gmail.com. And if you haven't yet, for some reason or another, subscribe to the channel. Maybe you're new. Maybe that's why you haven't done it. I definitely want to invite you to subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications so that you can stay abreast of all the content that I release on a weekly basis. Take care.